So welcome back to the Arts Garage, Dick Lowenthal's big band with a sweet new year.
I think you know that was Jingle Bells, right? We want to thank all of you for coming. It looks almost like pretty sold out, so we really appreciate that you guys are here. Thank you very much for showing up and supporting live music here at the Arts Garage. So that was, as I told you, Jingle Bells. It was written by this, you don't know, James Pierpoint. You never heard of him. But it was arranged by Billy Strayhorn, who wrote Take the A-Train for the Ellington Orchestra and a whole bunch of other songs. And he wrote it for the Duke Ellington Orchestra. It was recorded in 1962. In 1961, while appearing in Las Vegas, Ellington and Strayhorn decided to devote an entire album to arrangements of some other cat, as Dick would say. His name was Peter Tchaikovsky. And so they decided they would make a jazz arrangement of the Nutcracker Suite. So we're going to start playing just some movements from the Nutcracker Suite. This is the classical part of the program, okay? So we'll begin as the Tchaikovsky did, with the overture based on many of the themes that Ellington and Strayhorn arranged for the recording. So here is the opening overture to the Ellington and Strayhorn Nutcracker Suite. All right, so this second movement, I'll have to tell you, I have to read it, because this is, you'll see why in a minute. The second movement, Ellington originally called it Calliope Patootie, Toot, Toot, Tootie, Toot. Say it after me? No. Okay. But it was shortened to Toot, Toot, Tootie, Toot. That's easier, because people had trouble spelling it. So we'd like to do the second movement, and this is called Toot, Toot, Tootie, Toot. This next movement, which was the third movement in the Ellington Suite, this one you might recognize. This one is called the Peanut Brittle Brigade. And this is one of the few that has a solo for Duke Ellington. Most of the time he would either conduct from the piano, and if you look at a piece of music, everything says tacit, which means you don't play. But this Duke had a solo on here. Originally, it was a march in the Tchaikovsky Nutcracker Suite, and Duke and Billy transformed this into an up-tempo, stomping, romping tune. Here is Peanut Brittle Brigade. Thank you. And to close out this portion of the program, we're going to play the eighth movement of the Nutcracker Suite. This is like the Reader's Digest version of it. It's a little shorter. That was originally called Waltz of the Flowers. Duke and Billy wouldn't settle for that, so they called this 3/4 waltz. They wrote it in 4 beats to the measure, swinging, and called it the Dance of the Floridadors.
Thank you.
That's hard. That's a hard piece of music. And this is where I date myself, of course. This young man that we heard on trombone over here, we found out a couple years ago that I conducted him in the New Jersey High School All-State Jazz Band. And before we go too far, the fellow next to him, my daughter will remember because he always used to come over the house. That's Conrad Zuloff. And also high school and college and jazz workshops. I was very young when we did that. And he was too. How about another round of applause? That's awfully tough music. Okay, so as Suzanne said, this is a sweet new year. I didn't make a mistake in spelling it as S-U-I-T-E because we're doing pieces from various Duke Ellington suites that he wrote. Some of it you might have recognized that we just did. This next one, I doubt if anyone in the audience, no one in the band had ever heard this or played this. So she said you could dance. If you can find a place, we're going to do a very rare, rare two-minute Duke Ellington piece, a polka that he wrote. Okay, he actually wrote a polka. So Ellington was going to do, the band was going to be in residence in Madison, Wisconsin. And, thank you. And so he wrote a suite called the U.S. Suite. U-W-I-S, period, the U.S. suite. And he decided that they were going to be in the heartland of polkas and things like that. So he sent his drummer, Louis Belson, that some of you might know, married to Pearl Bailey, and played on The Tonight Show, split the drum chair with Ed Shaughnessy. So he told Louis to go down to Colony Records, which is a very, very big, famous record store in Manhattan. And he told Louis to buy every single polka record that they had. Okay, so he did, brought them back, and Ellington started playing all these. And so he came up with a two-minute polka. So if you find room, they did leave an aisle if you'd like to do a quick little polka back and forth. Oh, and this is also a period where Ellington was titling everything in four letters. So if we spell polka correctly, it's P-O-L-K-I, five letters. So he eliminated one of the letters. So this movement of the U.S. suite is called clop. I don't make this up. No polka dancers, huh? Thank you. Oh, you beat me to that. That's what Lawrence Welk would have said at the end of that, right? And then he would have said, go take a train. But anyway, well, this is another gentleman I knew from those days when he was with Woody Herman's band in residence at Ramapo College in New Jersey. This is Billy Ross. He was younger back then, a kid. They were students there, and Billy was with Woody's band in residence. And so we met a long, long time ago. Now, we have a real treat for you. We're going to bring our vocalist out. We've done many concerts here. Well, you haven't heard her yet. Oh. We've done many concerts here and around the county and stuff. She went to the University of Miami, got her bachelor's, master's, and doctorate at the Frost School of Music, won all sort of Downbeat Awards as a student, and has sung with all the named big bands all over the world. And we are very fortunate to have her here. She's head of the jazz vocal program at Florida International University and does a great job there. So we'd like to bring she's going to do four tunes. I'm giving her the band now. She's going to direct the band. So how about a nice warm welcome, please, for Lizanne Lyons.
Oh, wow, such power. I just wanted to, sit over there in the audience and hear this great band, because this is really hard stuff. And I grew up listening to the Nutcracker, the original, of course, Tchaikovsky, and dancing in my backyard with my little toe shoes and putting together, all my kids in the neighborhood. We put on shows, and it was the Nutcracker. So, it resonates with me, and to hear a jazz version of it, it's really cool, too. But I digress. So we're going to do some tunes for you, some great holiday tunes. And this first one is actually not a Christmas song, but it's always done during the holidays because it's about keeping your love warm and keeping, cozy. But we don't have a hard time in Florida with that because it's always warm, right? So we're going to do a tune that Ella Fitzgerald did. And we hope you enjoy. This is entitled, I've Got My Love to Keep Me Warm. I have my cheat sheets because I sing this. It's been 2 years since we've sung Christmas songs. Since we've done live shows, so I have my little cheat sheet. So. Snow is snowing, the wind is blowing, but I can weather the storm. What do I care if icicles storm? I've got my love to keep me warm. I can't remember a worse December. Just watch those icicles form. What do I care if icicles form? I've got my love to keep me warm. Off with my overcoat, off with my glove. I need no overcoat, I'm burning with love. My heart's on fire, the flame grows higher. I will weather the storm, the storm, the storm. What do I care if icicles form? I've got my love to keep me warm. Thank you. Clayton Chapman. Off with my overcoat, off with my glove. I need no overcoat, my head burning with love. My heart's on fire, my flame grows higher. But I can't weather the storm, the storm, the storm. What do I care if icicles form? I've got my love to keep me warm. It's a great tune. Oh my goodness. This next tune is also, you know, it's a tune that all kids love to do and love to sing. And we're going to do this for you. Great arrangement. Tune doesn't need any title. You'll recognize it. Oh, you better watch out, better not cry, better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Oh, yo, yo, he's making a list, checking it twice, gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping, he knows if you're awake, he knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake. Oh, you better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Oh, he's making a list, he's checking it twice, gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping, he knows if you're awake, he knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake. Oh, you better watch out, better not cry, better not pout, telling you why. Santa Claus is coming. Santa Claus is coming to town. Now this next song is actually one of my favorite Christmas songs because, I don't know, it's just... it's so well written. And the story behind this tune, actually, I found out, was it was written during the summertime because these two gentlemen were very, very hot and warm in LA at the time they were writing this tune. And they had no air conditioning back in those days, so they thought, let's do something that makes us feel a little bit nice and cool. And of course, the gentleman's name is Mel Torme and Robert Wells. And of course, you know, I think he could retire on this one tune alone, I'm sure. But it became the iconic Christmas song. And we have a very beautiful arrangement for you that we'd like to do. And features our lovely woodwind section. And it's entitled, of course, The Christmas Song. I get to conduct the beginning. You know, pretend that I... No, I'm just kidding. I stay in my lane. Thank you. chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe helps to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight, for they know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Beautiful song. Like I said, I think he could have retired on that tune alone, but of course, he was an amazing singer, amazing drummer, amazing arranger. Another one of my favorite singers is the Miss Nancy Wilson. Yes, we lost her a few years ago, and I had the pleasure of actually meeting her, you know, and just a fabulous singer. Just until the day she died, she sang great. This song, to me, is synonymous with her, even though this is kind of based on Ella Fitzgerald, her arrangement, or actually arrangement that was written for her, but in my mind, it's Nancy Wilson that really had the quintessential tune. This is, once again, not a Christmas song, but done during the holidays, and it's entitled, What Are You Doing New Year's Eve? But we'll wait to the, yes.
There goes my ride.
There's your ride? Oh. Oh. Maybe it's much too early in the game. Ask you just the same, what are you doing New Year's? New Year's Eve. Wonder whose arms will hold you good and tight when it's exactly 12 o'clock the night. Welcoming in the new year, New Year's Eve. Maybe I'm crazy to suppose I'd ever be the one you chose. Out of a thousand invitations you received, but in case I stand one little chance, here comes that jackpot question in advance. What are you doing New Year's? New Year's Eve. Jackpot question in advance, what are you doing?
Applause again for Lizanne Lyons. So we're going to do one more tune and then take a break. Remind you that the bar is open if you'd like a cocktail or a soft drink or whatever. And we have a lot of wonderful music in the second half. We're going to be doing some Glenn Miller Christmas holiday songs, Stan Kenton holiday songs, some surprise duets for you. And so we have a lot of music we're going to play in the second half of the program. It'll only be, it's ridiculous to say a short 15 minutes, because I don't know what a long 15 minutes will be, but it's going to be about 15 minutes. This band is very multi-talented. A lot of great, great, great players, writers, singers. And we are very fortunate to have one of our alto players who also plays tenor and barre, flute and clarinet, and a few other things, and sings and writes and arranges, has his own band. And so he's going to do a little something different for you. So I'm going to let Greg come up and tell you about it, and then we will see you at the second half. How about a nice round of applause for Greg Diaz?
Hear that? That's my Christmas tie just went off. It was the only thing that I had that was festive. So we're going to close out the set with a tune that was written by the late, great Donny Hathaway in the year 1970. This is called This Christmas. It's a little different than what we've been doing before. I hope you enjoy this.
The mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better this Christmas. And as we trim the tree, how much fun it's gonna be together this Christmas. Fireside is blazing bright, we're caroling through the night. Shake your hand, shake your hand. Presents and toys are here. My life is filled with joy in you. This Christmas, and as I look around, your eyes outshine the town they do. This Christmas, is blazing bright, we're caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Shake your hand, shake your hand. I'm gonna get to know you better this Christmas. And as we trim the tree, how much fun is gonna be together this Christmas. Fireside is blazing bright, shake your hand, shake your hand. Merry Christmas! Joy!
Thank you very much.
Again, a nice round of applause for Greg Diaz. How about for the band? Thank you. We'll see you in about 15 minutes. Don't go away. We've got a lot of great music on the second half. Thank you. Of course, you recognize that, right? It was called Now I Lay Me Down to Weep. Actually, that was the original song title. And then Miller changed it to Moonlight Serenade. See, you're learning all this trivia here tonight. But why would we play that on a Christmas song? Because I guess about 15 or 20 years ago, a lot of the alumni of the Glenn Miller Orchestra decided to record a whole bunch of holiday albums. And all three of them over the years went platinum. It was incredible. They really struck it rich. So some of the arrangers, they wrote, like for instance, we're going to do Let It Snow, and it's arranged by a Floridian named Dave Volpe, and John LaBarber did a couple, and they were all done in the Miller style. And if you listen real carefully, you'll hear occasional little bit of Tuxedo Junction thrown in there or something else. So here is Let It Snow in the Glenn Miller style.
Okay. Two bars. One, two, one, two, three, four. Thank you.
Well, here's another tune in the Glenn Miller style, and I think you'll recognize Winter Wonderland. Somebody recognize it. And I want to remind you, there's plenty of room if you'd like to dance. Get up and dance. Would you like to hear one more Glenn Miller arrangement? Okay. That's the next piece, you have to say yes. This is arranged by John LaBarbera, who used to write for, if you came to the concert we did a while back on a tribute to Buddy Rich and Woody Herman and Maynard and Stan Kenton, John LaBarbera did a lot of writing for the Buddy Rich Orchestra and played a little bit of trumpet in that band too, and lives, I think, in Louisville, Kentucky. Ooh, not a good place to be now. But anyway, we have another horse coming up. And this is Sleigh Ride, right? He's been practicing all afternoon. So this is Leroy Anderson's Sleigh Ride.
One, two, three, four, one. Up.
Thank you. How about this band again? We're doing so many different kinds of music. It's really amazing. It's really amazing. And now we switch gears again. And one of the very famous band leaders was a gentleman from California, from Balboa, California. His name was Stan Kenton. And some of you might be familiar with him. Recorded lots of different type music, and toward the end of his career, a lot of rock music and what we call odd meter. And there'll be a quiz in the Jazz and Java class on Monday. So Stan agreed to do an album of holiday music, but he really had one thing that he said to the producers of this album. He agreed on this one condition. He would absolutely not record any songs about singing snowmen or flying reindeer. Stan was very serious about that, by the way. So here's two tunes from that album, and I highly recommend it. It's a beautiful album. This first one, and what they did, by the way, on the original album, they had four French horns and five trumpets and four trombones and a tuba and everything. It was beautiful orchestration, except that the arrangements didn't sell. So what they did is a fellow named Bob Kernow, who used to manage the band, rearranged the French horn parts for saxophones. So this is kind of another version of these tunes from that holiday album of Stan Kenton. So the first one is called Old Tannenbaum. And the next tune we'd like to play from that holiday music of Stan Kenton, it was arranged by Ralph Carmichael, who does a lot of Broadway shows. And this is called God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. Thank you. Okay. We'd like to, I hope you enjoy those. They're a little bit different, the Stan Kenton arrangements. So we would like to bring back one of our two vocalists. No, actually, it's a real pleasure to bring Lizanne back. We've done a lot of concerts together, and she always does a great job. So here's two more tunes that she's going to do for you. How about a nice round of applause for Lizanne Lyons? Hey!
Now this tune is it's just a fun tune. It's a fun tune to do, and has a lot of words, so I'm not going to take it too fast. For my sake. It's not for your sake. It's just for my sake. I'm getting older, man. The words are harder to get out. All right. And it's a fun tune. I think you recognize this. Old Mr. Gringo isn't gonna jingle the bells that a jingle all your troubles away. Everybody's waiting for the man with the bed, 'cause Christmas is coming again. He's got a sleigh full, it's not gonna stay full. He's got stuff to drop on every stop of the way. Everybody's waiting for the man with the bag. Christmas is coming again. He'll be with the answer to the prayers that you made through the year. You get yours. If you've done everything you should, extra special good, he'll make this December the one you remember, the best and the merriest you ever did have. Everybody's waiting for the man with the bag. Christmas is here again. Sure gonna jingle all the bells and a jingle all your troubles away. Everybody's waiting for the man with the bag. Christmas is here again. He's got a sleigh full, it's not gonna stay full. He's got stuff, he's dropping every stop of the way. Everybody's waiting with the man with the bag. Christmas is here again. He'll be here with the answer to the prayers that you made through the year. You get yours. If you've done everything you should, extra special good, he'll make this December the one you remember, the best and the merriest you ever did have. Everybody's waiting. They're all congregating, waiting with the man with the bag. Better watch out now. Got your Christmas list? You know, I don't think I've even done any shopping yet. This is pretty bad. I'm not in the Christmas spirit. I better get on it. How many days left we have here? I don't know. Nobody's counting. I don't know. Have you got all your Christmas gifts?
No.
No. See? I'm not the only one. So this next tune is actually a tune that was made famous by the late, great Miss Judy Garland. Meet Me in St. Louis. This is a tune that she sang in that movie, and it's a gorgeous, actually, it's second, probably my second favorite Christmas song to the Christmas song, and this is entitled Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. So this is our wish to all of you. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days. Dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together if the fates allow. Hang a shining star above the highest. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. From now on, golden days of yore, faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together if the fates hang a shining star above the highest. And have yourself a merry little Christmas. Yourself a merry little Christmas now.
Merry Christmas.
Pam Lyons.
Thank you.
Beautiful. She'll be back. I didn't tell you. No, but you'll be back in a couple of minutes. We're going to do something very special. This band is made up of so many great players. But we call him a snowbird, right? Jimmy, you a snowbird? Yeah. He leaves us every day. He doesn't like 95 degree and humidity. So he goes to New York where it's also 95 and humid. So. Thank you very much. So we'd like to do again, if you've probably long forgot hours ago, the name of this concert is Have a Sweet Holiday, a Sweet New Year. So this is from another suite
that was one of Ellington's most famous. It was called the Far East Suite. Again, 9 sections. You're lucky we're only doing one. But what's interesting is he wrote it, but not while he was, there's only one tune about Japan in there. Everything else is about the Near East, the Middle East, but they still called it the Far East Suite. And we'd like to do a composition that's going to feature Jim Hayward on alto saxophone. And I think during the course of the evening, you've heard almost everybody in the band solo. You know that they're great soloists. This was recorded by Duke in 1967. It was originally called Elf, but there is no city in Iran called Elf. So they changed it to Isfahan. And that is the name of the piece that we'd like to do now from the Far East Suite and feature Jim Hayward on alto saxophone.
Thank you.
So first of all, I want to thank all of you for coming. This is really, you've been a great audience. We're going to do a couple of tunes for us. And if you really applaud, to be honest, we have an encore. But let me introduce everybody in the saxophone section, starting on the end. Mike Brignola, Tom McCormick, Billy Ross on tenor, Greg Diaz, and Jim Hayward, who you just heard, the saxophone section. On trombone, on the end here, John Cricker, Dante Luciani, and Conrad Zuloff. Trumpets, Ryan Chapman, Doug Michaels, Steve Ahern, and Chaim Rubinoff. On piano, Dennis Petassi. On drums, Matt Calderon. And on bass, Paul Sutak. Who would have known? So we'd like to play one tune. These are duets. The first, Baby, It's Cold Outside, was written by Frank Lesser in 1944. It was in the 1949 film, Michael, where are you? What was the name of it? Neptune's Daughter. And the song is a call and response, which we learned in our jazz and Java class, back and forth between either instruments or people singing. But in the score itself, the host was called a wolf. And in the score, the guest, she was called a mouse. In the film, it was performed, and this is really going pretty far back, right? Ricardo Montalban. Oh, you see, she's saying, oh, I knew that, right? You were saying that. And Esther Williams. Okay. So we would like to bring up Ricardo. No, they're not here. So we would, oh, there you are. Why don't you move over so they can see you a little bit. So here are Greg and Lizanne to do Baby, It's Cold Outside, which is not in Florida. That's impossible, but...
Cold inside. It's cold inside. Turn the air down. I really can't
baby,
stay.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I got to go
baby,
away.
Baby, it's cold outside.
This evening has
been
that so
in.
Very nice.
I'll hold your hands, they're just like
my
ice.
My mother will start to worry.
Beautiful, what's your
my father
hurry?
Will be pacing the
listen
floor.
Listen to the fireplace.
So really, I'd better
be
scurry.
Beautiful, please
well,
don't
maybe
hurry.
Just a half a drink
put
more.
Put some records on while I
the
pour.
The neighbors might
but
think.
But baby, it's cold out there.
Say, what's in this
no
drink?
No caps to be out there.
I wish I knew
your
how
eyes are like starlight
to
now.
Break this spell.
I'll take your hand. Your hair looks
I
swell.
I ought to say no, no,
mind
no,
if
sir.
I'm moving
at
closer.
At least I'm gonna say that I
what's
tried.
What's the sense of hurting my
I really can't
well, baby,
stay.
Baby, don't hold back.
Oh,
baby,
but it's cold outside. I simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is
but
no.
But baby, it's cold outside.
The welcome has
lucky
been
lucky that you
so
dropped in.
Nice and warm.
Look out the window at that
my
storm.
My sister will be suspicious.
Gosh, your lips look delicious.
My brother will be there at the
waves
door.
Waves up in the far away
my
shore.
Maiden aunt's mind
ooh,
is vicious.
Your lips are delicious.
Well, maybe just a cigarette
never
more.
Never such a pleasure before.
I've got to get home.
Baby, you'll freeze out there.
Say, lend me your car.
It's up to your knees out there.
You really have
thrilled
been
when you touch my
so
hand.
Very grand.
How can you do this thing to
there's
me?
There's bound to be talk tomorrow.
Think of my lifelong
at
sorrow.
At least there will be plenty in flight.
Dip, you got pneumonia and
I really can't
get
stay.
Over that old doubt.
That's actually, baby, please go outside. That's the way it was supposed to be. I don't know. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just getting into it.
Okay. Movement two.
And then we wrote. You have a story for this next one,
oh,
don't
of course.
You? Of course. He knows all the history.
Before we do that, first of all, I want to thank all of you for coming. How about that cat on sound is absolutely fabulous. Noel Wiley. He's been here for hours with us, you know, during our rehearsal. And if you've been to other shows, you know, he does a fabulous, fabulous job. So occasionally you can want me even thank him, because without him being here, we wouldn't be able to do this. Also, all of these other people that you see that are sitting along the side there that helped you to your seat, as if you didn't know where your table was. But the Guild people, we thank you all for helping us, and they're here at every concert. It's a volunteer organization, and if any of you are interested, you can come and speak to them about volunteering here. Let's see who else. Well, I want to thank this band. How about this band? And Suzanne, who is, makes all the wonderful announcements and everything. And we are having a big gala. We invite you to come to that. It should be a great affair. And just on a personal note, a great trumpet player will be here about the second week in January. His name is Randy Brecker. And you might know him from Blood, Sweat, and Tears, and probably one of the world's greatest trumpet players. So if you get a chance to come see Randy and his wife Ada and a quintet, that should be a great concert. And lastly, I'm allowed to do this because I'm the leader. I want to thank my daughter and her husband for coming here. It's not often they get a chance to see the old man work, and so I'm really appreciative that they're here. So here is the Nat King Cole hit from 1951. It actually was originally called Incomparable. I told you were going to find something else. See? It was originally called that, and the producers decided to call it something else, so they changed the name of the tune to Unforgettable. All right? So that was 1951. Then Natalie Cole, in 1991, we reworked it, and here's a word that we learned the last couple of years, right? She actually did a virtual duet with her father, who had passed away, and they would show him, if you saw it live, with a scrim, and then Natalie singing with her father. It was a very moving thing, and I recommend all of you to listen on YouTube to Natalie and that. Very moving. But who would have ever thought you'd ever hear the word virtual again? Right? A lot of you go watching us in Zoom and streaming and all this kind of stuff. I remember seeing the Lincoln Center Jazz Orchestra, the great band led by Wynton Marsalis. They each recorded their part from their homes and then put it together, and it's fabulous. And a lot of the entertainers did that. Now they're starting to come out and play, and God only knows if we're going to be able to keep that up with what's going on now. But anyway, we are going to do Natalie and Nat, or...
Are you Nat?
Oh, they're figuring out now who is who. There's one hell of a time to decide that.
Calm down now.
So here is the beautiful arrangement of Nelson Riddle called Unforgettable. Probably your last chance to dance.
Unforgettable, that's what you are.
Unforgettable, though near or
like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more.
Oh, 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 unforgettable.
stay.
That's how you stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable to you.
Michaels on flugelhorn, Billy Ross on tenor, and the band. All right, I told you we had an encore, right? I can't fool this table. They were here all the time, right in the front. So this is, you wish everybody a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays, and most importantly, a healthy and happy holiday, right? So now they've sat long enough, right? You're going to help them sing a little bit. Well, it's going to be our own Arts Garage karaoke. So here is Auld Lang Syne. Let us be the first to wish you a Happy New Year. In, of course, the Glenn Miller style.
Yeah.